A while back, I was very interested in offering some more opportunities to our early childhood students, and so many of our students know somebody or love somebody with autism. I love somebody with autism, so I felt like this would be a good area to focus on, to have people that could be trained in this area while they're working on their associate's degree in early childhood education. And since there are primarily one in 58 children a year are diagnosed with autism, I thought it was really important. It could also be, you know, open up some employment areas for our students. So I set about writing the program, and after I wrote it, then I realized I had to have someone to teach it. And I wanted the experts. So after talking with several different people, I went to ACES for Autism, and they were immediately on board. They are currently serving children, and they are currently training their staff, and they thought this would be a great opportunity to have more people trained and for them to provide their expertise to our students.
Yeah, so Melissa Reese reached out to us, and this is actually something that's been in progress for a year plus now, and COVID hit, and that kind of, you know, kind of stopped things for a little bit, and Mackenzie Sandler, our clinical director, and I were able to get on a call with Melissa, and it kind of really came together really quickly, and it's been awesome. It's kind of one of our visions at ACES for Autism is community outreach, and this falls right in line with that, is it us being able to serve the community, educate, you know, Pitt Community College students about what autism is, how they can get involved in the profession. ACES for Autism was established in August 2014, and it started with the story of our son Samuel. My wife Bobby and I, our oldest son is 9 years old, and he's on the autism spectrum. Back in 2014, some individuals in the community reached out to us and was like, we want to do something to help your son. At the time, there was not a treatment center for autism in Eastern North Carolina, so my wife and I decided to research and find a place to go when he got diagnosed, and settled on Winston-Salem, ABC of NC in Winston-Salem. So after that first year, some those individuals reached out to us and really wanted to do something. That's where, when God really laid upon our hearts, hey, instead of just doing something for Samuel, let's start a nonprofit and let's bring a center to Eastern North Carolina to serve children and families impacted by autism. We started providing actual services in the spring of 2016. Oakmont Church donated their preschool wing where we got started. And then we really needed a space where we could serve more children and families and grow while we continue to fundraise for the campus we're going to build out in Winterville. The 24 acres of land that we have in Winterville is going to have a campus where it'll have a clinic, a non-traditional school, a recreational space, and a family services space. So it'll be a true campus-like feel where really anything an individual with autism needs service-wise will be on that one campus. For Bobby and I, it's just been overwhelming and just amazing the doors that God has opened and the individuals that have decided to walk alongside us and be a part of ACES as we try to impact more children and families in Eastern North Carolina.
It's a very unique program that I'm really excited to be heading with Melissa as kind of the guide. The class itself is called Autism Technical Concepts, which really branches this opportunity for students to not only learn about autism and applied behavior analysis, but they get to experience it, they get to come and do their practicum with professionals, with BCBA supervisors, with the RBTs, which are registered behavior technicians that work directly with our kids that have autism. So they get to come see and feel the entire spectrum of autism. They get to see how applied behavior analysis, what it looks like, the joys and benefits of it, and the hard work that the kids and the techs put in day by day. So they get to learn piece by piece, and then every week their topic that they explore with me in their virtual class, then they get to come and experience it and observe it or go in and actually try it themselves in the clinic with the actual kids with autism. So it's a really unique kind of hands-on experience that a lot of people really don't get. Something to get into this field, typically people become registered behavior technicians, and to do that you have to take a 40-hour course. So typically it's online, webinar style, you know, go at your own pace, you watch some stuff, you take some tests, and you get your 40 hours. But with this class, you actually get live experience. So it's very unique. It's, it gives people with different learning styles the ability to learn how they would want to learn. So that's kind of the unique perspective of it. And the end result, when you're done with the class, you actually are prepared and have finished all of your requirements to sit for the national RBT exam. So it gives them an opening into a career, which is really cool. So we have kids as young as 2.5, all the way up to 17 years old, and every child's unique. The spectrum of autism is such a unique diagnosis that every kid really brings their strengths and their abilities with them every day. So, you know, we have children that speak amazingly and can get their point across very strongly. And we've got other kids that use picture exchange or devices to speak for them. You know, kids that have really tough days and kids that have amazing days throughout the entire week, throughout all levels of the autism spectrum. And we don't just serve kids from Pitt County, from the local Greenville area. Some of our families travel in over an hour to get here from various counties such as Martin, closer to Nash County and Wilson. So we're really able to serve a wide variety of children and families, not necessarily just from the immediate area.
I am so thankful for the partnership that we've gained with ACES for Autism. They've been so open to every idea we had, so flexible in providing the needed coursework that our students need. And they're really providing this top-notch experience for them, the students, to do in their practical work. So I'm really honored to be having that opportunity to work with Kyle and his crew, and I foresee really good things happening in the future.